Hi, in this video I want to demonstrate just briefly a few features of a new web application that DiRoots is developing. It's called Stellar. It starts with IFC Viewer, and we have a long roadmap to implement some features and workflows that we want to give you as a community. So let me show you just briefly. If you click plus, you can load the certain IFC model. You can load more than one IFC model. The best part is that this model stays on your machine. Although it's in the web browser, it uses your hardware resources to process, render geometry, and manipulate. We don't upload anything to our servers. Our server serves just to deploy this application to your machine, and that's it. And if you visit website, you can access the IFC viewer. So let's start. The first part, geometry, you can rotate, pan, zoom. That's fine, all usual stuff. So what you can see also is a data attached to the IFC model. So let me just expand briefly a list. And of course, you can see properties. So at this stage, I have this element selected, but I can select some other element, and you will see that whatever I select in tree view or in the graphics, it will synchronize and find the elements on both sides. So let's suppose I selected this roof. And I see now the properties, and I can expand properties, I can collapse some sections, right? Or I can expand all the sections. So it is important to notice that you see the graphics in a main viewer, and you see, of course, data with all the IFC classification classified elements and their appropriate descriptions and so on. So let's close this. The next interesting thing is that you can use different ways to preview the model. So, for example, isometric view will look something like this. Okay, so you see an isometric, and of course you can use top, for example, top view, which is isometric or orthographic projection from the top and so on. Let me now go to perspective, because for me personally it's a bit easier and more easier to see, visualize the model. So one of the unique features that we have is walking through the floor plans. So look, this one, we can go to the floor plan, we can go to other floor plan and another, and we can see that we are cutting the model. So it looks something like this. Of course, you can select elements, you see the hover highlights. Okay, let's now go to perspective, and let me show a few additional features that we have. Let's suppose that this view is interesting to you. For some reason, you are reviewing the model. And what you can do, you can take a screenshot. So if I open this screenshot in a default image viewer, it will look something like this. Because I'm running 4K machine or 4K display, the image will be high resolution. So it will take a resolution of your canvas, right? The other interesting features are something like this. If you go to cut planes, you can activate cut planes by clicking select from face. Actually, you can pick any face, doesn't matter the orientation, and you will see the preview. And of course, you can cut the model to see what's inside the model, right? You can add more than one cut plane. So let's pick, for example, this face, and let's indent a bit. And to make things even more interesting, let me show you that you can select any kind of face. As an example, this one, which is relatively slanted. And you see how this cut plane is under a certain angle based on the face that we selected. Okay, so let's suppose that this very strange combination of cut planes is something that is interesting to me. I want to keep them. So what I can do, I can deactivate them and see the whole model. Okay, or I can activate them again to see them. But if I'm satisfied, I can just remove the cut planes. So next time I can set new cut planes. Okay. So that is the first part. Application at this stage supports light and dark theme. So however you prefer to visualize your model, as an example, all UI will now be in the dark theme. Let me show you how now properties look like. Right. Everything is in dark theme. Let me switch to the light one. And of course, at this stage, we will try to out-of-box support as many as possible languages. So at this stage, we support English and Portuguese, but we have planned for Spanish, German, French, and list goes on. Like, there will be a list of languages that we'll support, and you see that we are kind of supporting the localization. So let's go back to English. And let me show you a few interesting things. If I go to application preferences, I can set my units. So for example, for length, I can visualize units in meters, millimeters, feet, inches. So both imperial and metric measurement systems are supported. Same goes for area, volume, for example. And for unit rounding, we have these options to kind of round the units. And of course, let's start from this side. What you can turn on is stats, frames per second. For example, I'm running 30 frames per second easily on my machine. And you see, for example, RAM memory usage consumption, because all the processing, as I said, is on your model, on your machine. So you don't use any hardware resources from the DiRoots servers. Everything is processed using your CPU, GPU, RAM memory, and so on. So usually you will not care about this stuff. This is something that DiRoots cares. But in case you want to inspect the stats, you can always turn on. Gizmos are origin point access. If you want to see XYZ origin, you see it's drawn here. Let's suppose that I want just to see Z axis for some reason. And of course, you can turn on the grid. So you can fit in the context the model, right? So you see the grid, it's 10 by 10 meters. Of course, you can make it 1 by 1 meter, or let's leave by 10 by 10. Okay. The next interesting thing that we can do in application preferences is maybe let's turn off the grid. Let's go to materials. Okay. And let's override materials. And let's use one of these colors. Okay. So we can see the model in the color. And we will override all the materials that are coming from the IFC with a clay default material. Sometimes it's useful to inspect the you know, shape of geometry, or just remove obstruction made by material colors. Let me go to this color. Of course, you can pick any that you want, right? And you can set the transparency of the model. So let us close to apply. And model looks now like this. Let us even push a bit more. Let us set the transparency to be high, around 50% roughly, right? So we can see through the model. And of course, all the selections, all of these features are working like it should be. And let's reset the transparency. Let's move 100%. By the way, if you want to see the wireframe model, you can just remove transparency to be zero, and then you can turn edge visualization. So let's suppose that we would like to see edges to be this color. I don't know. Softness is a threshold for setting up the where edges will be drawn, because on this default level, you will see boundary edges of faces. But if you go and increase the threshold, you will see internal divisions of faces in the meshes. So let's go like this. It will need a second, and that's it. So you see now edges are applied, and you can easily inspect your model. So there is more than this. Actually, this is in beta. We are actively developing features and tools inside the Stellar application, Stellar IFC Viewer, as I said, starts with IFC Viewer to summarize, but it goes far beyond just a viewer. Let me just give you a couple of clues. Automated model checking and some other things said. So hope you enjoy. Soon we will release access and share with you the URL where you can visit this application. And as always, one of the key takeaways is, even regarding the privacy, security, and so on, keep in mind that all the things that you see here, they don't go outside of your machine. They are exactly on your machine using your hardware resources. No need to upload models to DiRoots servers. So it's using local models from your machine. And that's it. Thank you, and hope you enjoy. See you. Bye.